Hello everyone, Reza here, welcome to my channel. Let's talk about one of the coolest features inside Character Creator 5, the Headshot 2 plugin. If you ever wanted to bring your custom head sculpts from ZBrush or scans into CC5 and instantly turn them into a fully rigged character, this is the tool you've been waiting for. Headshot 2 lets you import external head models, wrap them perfectly to the CC base mesh and preserve all the sculpted details with subdivision and normal map baking. Basically, it bridges your sculpting software with real-time characters for animation or even Unreal Engine projects. In this quick walkthrough, I will show you exactly how to set it up, start a project, and get those details transferred cleanly. So let's dive in and see how powerful this plugin really is. I'm going to start in Autodesk Maya, but you can be in Blender, ZBrush, Mudbox, really doesn't matter. What I have is a very high density, high quality female head mesh, and I would like to attach that to a body, fix the proportion, fix the topology, add rig to the character, and potentially add animation to it. No, you know better than me that this process takes a very long time, and that's why perhaps I picked Headshot in Character Creator 5, because you can expedite the process and get to the finished result really, really fast. I'm going to select the mesh and I'm going to export that as FBX. That's the preferred extension for Character Creator 5. Export, and let's see first where we can find Headshot 2 in Reallusion Hub. It is a plugin here, as you can see, that I have already installed, and it's compatible with CC5 at the time of the recording. It's version 2.0. Now we know where to find it and how to install it. Let's open Character Creator 5. I'm inside the application. First, you import the head model into Character Creator as a prop. So I'm going to go File, Import, Import. This is version 2, open, and it's very important to import it as a prop. Halfway through the process, we don't even need that, we can remove it. So I'm just going to convert it, just going to reposition it. You don't really need to do it, but I just want to get a better lighting. Now, very important, when you bring it, just press F to realign it with the camera. That is a requirement. Where to find Headshot 2? If you look in the toolbar, we have Headshot 2.0 and two buttons where you can import from a texture, high quality 4K preferably texture, or you can bring a high quality sculpt and project that to your CC base mesh. I'm going to click, make sure the character is selected when you select the headshot, and this is the user interface. Mesh is selected. You can see that we have some reminders. Align the head with the camera, frame the camera to encompass the head, and that's perhaps why we pressed F on the keyboard to get into this camera angle. I'm going to click on Start Head Generation. First step is the align points, where you mark key areas on your model, like eyes, nose, mouth. So the plugin knows how to wrap the CC base mesh onto your sculpt. Once that's lined up, you can go to the next step. It's in the sequential order, and we are in step one. Now, in terms of alignment points, we have 24 points, 32 points, and 35 points. With 35 points, you include ears and the back of your head and inside the lips as well. I'm gonna click auto detection. auto detection is just going to have a great guess at the first 24 points, and the rest you need to add manually. Even though it's an automated process, I always go ahead and try to compare to make sure that I have the right locations per points. Seems like it's done a pretty good job, actually. Apart from the nostrils, I can move the nostrils here. What about number 18? That needs a bit of adjustment here. The eyes look good, eyebrows are good, and we can continue adding extra points, mainly for the ears, back of the head, under the chin, and around the lips. So far I've got 24, so I'm going to continue with 25, 26, and 27, making sure that the position of it is roughly the same position. Then 28, 29, and 30. Yep, pretty good. Top of the head, we have 31. And the back of the head, we have 32. Under the chin, we have 33. Just need to be a little bit careful with that. Yeah, more or less, it's kind of the same area. Perhaps I can just move it ever so slightly to the right position and offset that to the right hand side, something like that. That should work. And now I can zoom in and work out 34 and 35. All right, that should do the trick. More or less, it's accurate. Let's move on to the next step, head generation. At this stage, the character creator roughly is going to reshape the embedded base model to match your imported sculpt. So we wait for it to bake, and this is what we get. Basically, the application would like to know if you just want to include this bit, you want to include the face, but not the back of the face and the neck or everything. You can totally customize that. As a matter of fact, that's the method I'm going to go for, because I'm not too happy with the bottom of the neck. It's asymmetrical, as you can see. So when you select, you're holding down Shift to add and Control Shift to remove. Very straightforward. So what I can do is to select everything and then Control Shift to just remove this part of the head that I kind of dislike. Shift to add more, Control Shift to remove. That really should do it. Nothing else is needed. Let's move on to the next step. You jump into refine mesh step. Here you can increase the subdivision level. And in this particular step, as you can see, the mesh can hold much more detail. If things start to lag while sculpting or tweaking, you can always drop down the subdivision. But I'm going to add one, so I'm going to go into subdivision level 2. This allows me to sort of get into more accurate pose. Now, I'm being really anal about this, to be honest with you. I can totally let this go, but perhaps I can just ever so slightly push that to the level that I want. What about the chin? Yep, maybe that as well. I'm going to increase the intensity. Push that in just a little bit. The rest is really good, actually. Maybe forehead, just a tad. And I really don't mind this very, very minor misalignment. I can totally kind of ignore that, if I may. So that is all done. It's time to attach that to a body. And after this point, we no longer need this sculpt, and this head will be attached to a character creator body with all the bells and whistles. I'm going to go attach to body. In here, it's going to ask what sort of diffuse color you would like to add. Would you like to keep some normals from your original sculpt? I'll don't mind that. Diffuse color from my original sculpt, I do not have anything, so I'm going to go textureless. body type, male or female, mine is female, texture mask, no mask. I would like to have the entire head, and I'm gonna go and generate. First you have the geometry, then it fixes the pose, and then it replaces the head. It's really magical what you see on the screen, but believe it or not, that's pretty much it. It might take a minute or two, so stay patient. You can see the base model appears first, and then it fixes the pose into the default pose, and the head will be replaced with what we have, and the texture will be removed because we said that, well, our diffuse source doesn't have any texture, so it's going to remove it for us. Rest assured, we're going to add it in a second. Now we have the character. I believe that the neck needs to be elongated just a tad. Perhaps we don't need this sculpt. I can get rid of it. So I've already covered how to use morph, but rest assured, this is a fairly straightforward process. You can make it wider if you want. You've got so much control over these characters. It's just unbelievable. But for now, that really should do the trick. Now, the character looks really odd because it doesn't have texture, it doesn't have hair, it doesn't even have eyeballs. So I'm going to speed up a video a little bit because after this point, mission is accomplished. We just need to add accessories, skin texture, and all of this from the character creator templates and bundle assets. It might take a time, but it's something that is based to your taste and you don't really need to follow along. I'm just going to go ahead and add textures, hair, outfit, and we're going to prepare the character for the animation. Alright, so after trying out a bunch of different styles and outfits, I finally got the character dressed up. We started with just a head sculpt that was made in ZBrush, then cleaned up in Maya. And before you know it, I got it fully on a character with animation. That's the power of headshot. Let's take a quick look at the head and make sure it follows the body nicely. No weird artifacts or distortion. I'm especially checking the neck area. Yeah, that looks solid. Now imagine doing all of this the old school way. Retopology, proportions, body creation, rigging, outfit, animation in multiple software packages. That would have taken ages. But now with this workflow, you've got something ready to export to other DCCs and to refine further. All right, that should do it for this tutorial. Now you've got a good idea on how headshot bridges your custom model into the CC ecosystem. So once it's converted, your new head works seamlessly with hair, clothing, skin details, facial expressions, and animation, just like any native CC character. I've dropped the link to Character Creator 5 in the description so you can check it out. Thank you so much for your ongoing support on Patreon. If you're enjoying this tutorial, make sure to like and to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.